So let us see what the third question is. So the third question says that for isomerization reaction of compound F to compound G, Arrhenius constant is given by the equation A equal to A naught E power some E A by R T, where A naught E A R and T are pre-exponential factor, and A naught is given as E power 35, which is the activation energy. Universal gas constant, which is R, this R is universal gas constant. Temperature is T. Okay, then Arrhenius equation gives the temperature dependence of the reaction rates. For different values of temperature T, Arrhenius constant A are given in the table. So for different T's, these different A's are given. So if we use the method to minimize the sum square error, which is SSE, what is the most likely activation energy from the given options? So EA is the activation energy. So let us see what this thing says. So you can take log on both sides. So log we are taking as base as E. So I am using this notation ln, and here also this term will come before ln E. So this will be our equation if we take log. So this will give us this ln E is 1, so EA by RT. So we can write it like this way. So this is in the form Y equal to MX plus C, where Y is ln A, which is our dependent variable, X is 1 by T, which is the independent variable, M is the slope, which is given as EA by R, and our constant C is ln of A naught. Now A naught is given as e power 35, so it will be e power 35, which is nothing but 35. So C is 35. Okay, so we are taking X as 1 by T. So these are T1, T2, T3 and T4. So we can write, calculate what are XI. So X1 is 1 by T1, which we will get, if we calculate, we will get 0.0013. You can do the calculation by yourself. So I am just writing these values. So these are four values of XI, where I runs from 1 to 4. Okay, so what we have to calculate the SSE? So for different XI, we will get different YI using this equation, where M will vary depending on these four options. So there are four possible M. So let us write this. For option 1, I am writing it as M1. So if we calculate M1, which is minus EA by R, and I am taking the first EA, first option 272 as my first EA. So I am getting minus 32716. So what we are doing here, EA is given as 272 kilojoule, but this you can observe that the universal gas constant is given as joule, mole inverse and kelvin inverse. So basically for EA 272, we have to take 272000. So this we have to convert it in terms of joule, and then we have to divide it with the universal gas constant, which is 8.314, and there is a minus. So if we calculate this, then you will get this one. Similarly, you can calculate M2 as 32716, M3 as minus 52,682, and M4 as 52,682. So these are the four possibilities for M1, M2, M3 and M4. Now see what SSE is. So SSE is basically sum square error. So if I put different values of XI, you will get different Y. and the error will be this yi minus that y which are we getting by putting defined xi. So the error will be yi minus mxi minus c. We have to take the square of this error because this is squared error, and we have to take sum of this. So this is our SSE I equal to 1 to 4. So this is the formula for SSE. Now here for different option we are getting different MI. So SSE for option 1, so for 4 different option we have to calculate the SSE and we have to see which one is the minimum. So SSE for option 1 will be I equal to 1 to 4 yi minus m1 xi minus c whole square. So you have to just put this xi, put the first m1 here, c is same for all the terms, so which is 35, and you have to subtract that from this yi and take the square of it and take the sum of it. So if you calculate this, you will see the first one you will get something like 1.18 plus 0.0006 plus 0.009 plus 0.001. And if we calculate for the second option you will see the first term alone, which is y1 minus m2 x1 minus c whole square, plus there are three more terms. So the first term alone will give you 7421, and there are three more terms, and all these terms are positive because these are squares, so it is definitely greater than the first option. Now again if we calculate for option 3, again you will see the first term will be 618, and there are some three more terms. If we calculate option 4 and observe only the first term, you will get 12,567 and some three more terms. So observe that all these terms are much greater than this option 1. So option 1 will give you the least SSE. So option 1 is the correct option.